Welcome back to part 2 of our comprehensive guide on fixing the HDMI issue with the Sony Alpha 7 III. In the first video, we covered various troubleshooting steps to determine if the problem is hardware related. If you haven't watched part 1 yet, be sure to do so to confirm that you're dealing with this common hardware problem. Now, let's dive into the repair process to resolve this issue and find out why it happened. Stay tuned and let's get started. Over the years, we've repaired several Alpha 7 III cameras with HDMI issues, and almost all of them had the same hardware problem. Let's disassemble this one to see if it has the common issue or not. Before disassembling the camera, remove the SD cards and battery. This camera didn't come with an iCup. If you have one, push it here to open the compartment. There are a lot of screws we need to remove. Don't worry, we'll sort them in order. And at the end of the video, I'll show you where each screw goes. First, remove these 9 Phillips screws and group them together as group 1. All of them are the same. After unscrewing all the screws, carefully remove these metal components. You'll find 2 more screws hidden under the SD card door. Remove these and add them to group 1. Next, open the audio and video doors and add these screws to group 1. Note that this shorter screw belongs in group 2. Gently lift the LCD screen. You'll find a screw underneath that belongs in group 2. Unscrew the 4 screws surrounding the viewfinder. These screws belong in group 1. Use your finger to hold the diopter adjustment dial steady while you unscrew it. Set the diopter dial aside in a safe place. Peel back just this side of the grip rubber. You'll find 2 screws underneath. Remove these and add them to group 3. Now, you can remove the front part of the camera. Carefully pry it apart from the seam. Remove these doors and set them aside. We'll reattach them during reassembly. There's a flat ribbon cable connecting the front part to the main board. Be careful not to lift the front part too high before disconnecting this cable. To disconnect the flat ribbon cable, gently lift the retaining clip on this side of the ZIF socket with a spudger. Everything we need to access is now visible, so we don't need to open any other parts. Let's take a look at the HDMI circuit under the microscope. Don't forget to remove this cover. This is the micro HDMI socket. You can see four common mode filters on its signal lines. All we need to do for troubleshooting is check the connection between these components and the HDMI socket pins with a multimeter in buzzer mode. There's no connection here. Or here either. Yes, as I expected, we are dealing with that common hardware problem on this camera. Let's go ahead and check the other traces. That's strange. There's no connection here either. Fortunately, this one is connected. So, as you can see, these tracks look fine, but are not connected. These two filters are also connected to the pins in the back row, which we can't access directly. To check the connections, plug in your HDMI cable. There are small holes on the HDMI A side of the cable where the HDMI pins are located. Gently insert the needle probe into these holes and check the connection between the pins and the filters. Check the connections in the order shown in the video. Everything looks good here. The issue usually isn't with these components. We've discovered that three traces are disconnected. Let's determine the cause of this issue and solve it. Our inspection shows that the micro HDMI socket on the Alpha 7-3 is mounted on a very thin part of the PCB. This means that every time you plug in the HDMI cable, the PCB flexes and the socket pins can separate. In severe cases, this can even damage the traces and cause disconnection. To prevent this issue from recurring, consider handling the port with extra care and using an HDMI cable clamp to repair the disconnected traces. We'll resolder them. Apply flux to the area and carefully solder the socket and filters pins. Be extra cautious when soldering near the filter pins to avoid overheating them. Don't forget to clean the board before testing the connections. Since the common mode filters are showing a 0 ohm resistance between the pins, we'll check the connectivity between the HDMI socket pins and the points on the opposite side of the filters. Great! All connections are corrected. If you're still getting no connection, you'll need to expose the copper tracks by scratching off the solder mask. Then apply solder to these exposed tracks. Alternatively, you can use a jumper wire, but this can be more challenging. Before reassembling the camera, let's verify the HDMI connection by testing it with a monitor. First, reattach the plastic cover. Now, carefully connect the flat ribbon cable. Finally, attach the two doors. They are not identical, so align them with their respective curved edges to ensure they fit correctly. Now we can power on the camera and test it. Well done! The HDMI is working perfectly. Before we reassemble the camera, if you're finding this video helpful, please like and subscribe. Your engagement drives us forward. Let's put this camera back together. You can see the exact screw sizes for each group displayed on the screen. Tighten the two silver screws from group 3 in place here. Now, tighten one screw from group 2 between the two doors and three screws from group 1 in the remaining holes. Tighten four screws from group 1 around the viewfinder. Now, insert the diopter adjustment dial at the correct angle. Hold it in place and tighten its screw. Put this metal part back in and tighten 9 screws from group 1. Tighten the remaining two screws from group 1 under the SD card door. Finally, tighten the last screw from group 2 under the LCD. If you have any questions, comment down below. That's it for today's video. See you in the next one.